Good evening, one and all, present over here on the screen and off the screen. I am Nisha Upadhyaya, currently working for Scheme for Protection and Preservation of Endangered Languages, CIIL. On behalf of the Central Institute of Indian Languages, Mysore, and Linguistic Society of India, Pune, I welcome all the dignitaries, the guests, the delegates, and all the participants who have joined us from across India and other parts of the globe on this visual platform. It is a pleasure to be here at the valedictory session of the 43rd International Conference of Linguistic Society of India. The session will unfold as follows. To begin with, we'll have a valedictory lecture by Padma Shri Professor D.P. Patnaik, the founder director of CIIL. Then we'll have the remark from our editor, Professor Umarani Papuswamy, followed by the conference report by Sri Shujoy Sarkar, coordinator of ICALC 43. Next, we have the remark of Professor G. Uma Maheshwara Rao, President, Linguistic Society of India. Then we have the remark of the chairperson, Professor Sailendra Mohan, the director of CIIL, followed by the vote of thanks by Dr. Pankaj Dwivedi, coordinator, ICALC 43. Then we'll have close the ceremony with a national anthem. So without further delay, may I request you to allow me to begin the session. For the valedictory lecture, we have Padma Shri Professor D.P. Patnaik as our speaker. I have the distinct pleasure to introduce the speaker and the guest of the day. Padma Shri Professor Devi Prasanna Patnaik is among the architects of Indian linguistics. He is the founding director of Central Institute of Indian Languages and is considered among the senior most linguists of the country. He has rendered decades of service to promote scientific studies of Indian languages, including their documentation and description as a first instance. He is also the former chairman of the Institute of Odia Studies and Research, Bhubaneswar. Professor Patnaik was awarded Padma Shri in the year 1987 for his tremendous contribution to formalize and adding Bodo language in the 8th schedule of the Constitution of India. He has played an instrumental role in getting Oriya the status of classical language. His works include Multilingualism in India, Intensive Hindi Course Drills, Language and Social Issues, Princess Leelavati Memorial Lectures, Papers in Social Linguistics, An Introduction to Tamil Script, Reading and Writing, Multilingualism and Mother Tongue Education, Language Policy and Program, Advanced Tamil Reader Part 1, and an outline of Komoni Grammar. And he has been honored with the Kalinga Sahitya Sanman in the year 2014, Tigiriya Sanman 2011, and Padma Shri in the year 1987. So over to you, sir. The session is yours.
Patnaik, sir.
Is he there?
Okay, he must have some connectivity issue. We can wait for a while until he joins. Okay, and he'll return, I guess.
His phone is busy. His phone is busy.
His phone is busy.
I'm helping him. Tariq, I think, calling. Dr. Tariq is calling, I think.
Okay.
sir. Please click on asking to join. Ha sir, when you click at ask to join, click on that button, sir.
Validatory function re address karibe apan te kindly join karantu Google Meet re amu to kauthile apan university palai asantu kariya boli is unable to join it seems
why
telling that I'm trying it is not connected it seems.
Oh can you just who can is there anyone who can assist him there
I'm trying that I think he's facing some technical difficulty let okay. us try for some time
right
We are discussing for a long time. If you could have reminded me, I could have called you. I have told sir.
This fellow.
Guru sir.
Hmm. Yeah.
That Shalendra sir has already joined.
I don't think so. But
yeah, Tariq, can we start with the conference report in the meantime?
Has Professor Patnaik joined because he was struggling with some link?
Link I have already sent.
I am calling him right away because he he joined another different link and he called me.
Oh, so
short while ago he was here. I saw him.
The link is available on his WhatsApp.
He has too many links on his WhatsApp.
So he can use any link then.
Yeah, send a cut and paste. Okay.
Yes.
Actually, he is trying, but I guess he is clicking on some wrong link. We are coordinating. Please patiently wait.
Hello.
And okay. We'll begin shortly.
Hello. Yeah, so the link ends
when
with
I take a wrong e. when I take a wrong e. link e. I get my BP up because we are losing our time, that's why. So probably he's also finding the same problem.
I think he's on some other call also simultaneously.
I think
no, he's with me. He's joining in 1 second. I'm just guiding him.
Oh, you are there with him. Okay, then. He's with you means he's in Mysore?
No, Bhubaneswar.
Oh, Bhubaneswar. Uma Rani is in my Bhubaneswar.
Madam,
only online with me. Oh, Shubham is calling. Ha, Shubham. Hello. Hello. నేను దీంట్లో ఉన్న కాన్ఫరెన్స్ వెల్ డెక్టరీ సెషన్ జరుగుతుంది. ఓకే.
Okay, you have joined. Please join.
Session managers, please restart the process.
With your permission, I would like to reintroduce Professor Patnaik, considering the technical problems he had. I have the distinct pleasure to introduce the guest of the day, Padma Shri Professor Debi.
Yes.
Padma Shri Professor Debi Prasanna Patnaik is among the architect of Indian linguistics. He is the founding director of CIIL and is considered among the senior most linguists of the country. He has rendered decades of service to promote scientific studies of Indian languages, including their documentation and description as a first instance. He is also the former chairman of the Institute of Oriya Studies and Research, Bhubaneswar. Professor Patnaik was awarded Padma Shri in the year 1987 for his tremendous contribution to formalize and adding Bodo language in the 8th schedule of the Constitution of India. He played an instrumental role in getting Oriya the status of classical language. His work includes multilingualism in India, intensive Hindi courses, drill, language and social issues, Princess Leelavati Memorial Lectures, papers in Indian linguistics, an introduction to Tamil script, reading and writing, multilingualism and mother tongue education, language policy and program, Advanced Tamil Reader Part 1, an outline to Komoni grammar. He has been also honored with Kalinga Sahitya Samman 2014, Tigiriya Samman in the year 2011, and the Padma Shri 1987. Over to you, sir. The session is yours.
Yes, I have a little what are you? Who Hello.
Sir,
hello.
Hello. Hello, sir. Please. Yes. Good evening, sir. You can start.
Sir, you can start. You're audible, sir.
I shall start.
Yes.
I shall begin saying a few words about myself because I don't think people know. They said that I was the founder director of the CII. I retired as the additional secretary to the Government of India, Department of Human Resource Development. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Hi. So, among my publications, volumes that were released by President Pranab Mukherjee are Language and Cultural Diversity. It consists of 8 books. It is published by Orion Black Swan. Now, I am going to begin to say what I want to say as the valedictory address. Linguistics in India is on the decline. Indian languages are being undermined. After a debate in the Constituent Assembly about national language, finally English was declared as the official language of India. Subsequently, Hindi was accepted as the official language, even a 15 years extension. After English was declared as the only language of knowledge and development, it became the medium of education. There is no wonder that English became the aspirational language for the future generations. The colonial intellectuals told us that the Indians didn't know how to write history because they had no history. Today, what goes on in the name and blind faith. Thereafter, we started looking at ourselves through their lenses. Study of Sanskrit, which was the storehouse of knowledge in and about ancient India, was pushed. Sanskrit learning was denied to the Indians, but research centers were opened in London, Paris, and New York. The Americans discovered that Sanskrit was best suited for being the computer language. Because of the imposition of Baccalaureate monomodal education system over a multilingual and multicultural India, devastating. In spite of 3,000 mother languages, 4,000 castes and communities, 4,000 religious faiths and beliefs, 45,000 animal varieties, 65,000 tree and plant varieties, MB MNO of USA and T. Barrow of UK announced India as a single language and cultural area. This doesn't seem to have influenced Indian linguistics to any great extent. Rather, the fact that the West didn't recognize bilingualism until 1961 and multilingualism until 2010 had tremendous influence on the Indian linguistic scene. Suniti Kumar Chatterjee, in his Arthapallabhanti Memorial Lecture 1964, writes, "Language unit is a single unit where we consider its basic culture besides its geography, history, and economy. Diversities of its race and languages are there. Talking about exclusiveness, the genius of the creators of Indian civilization, of the Indian way of life, has succeeded in integrating them into a single unit." Unquote. No serious attempt is made to study this integration and resolve controversy. In the face of grave opposition, I succeeded in persuading the UGC to establish a professorship of India as a linguistic area in the Usmania University. In the absence of encouragement, the post was continued. The same thing has happened to linguistics in the absence of developmental planning. In the 70s, I, with the support of UGC and the Ford Foundation, hosted an 8-week course in sociolinguistics. Scholars from the USA, including William Lamb, UK, Canada, and Europe, participated. 30 to 40 linguistic faculty members joined, but sociolinguistics as a subject did not take root in Indian universities. 30 years after this event, I started a separate department of sociolinguistics in the Utkal University of Culture. It was dissolved after 2 years after I distanced myself from the university. In the early 70s, the first course in India as a computational linguistics was offered by CIL in collaboration with the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, where after 40 years I met Dr. Sierra Rao. He still cherished this memory. But computational linguistics did not take root in Indian universities. With the TIL, we started the Corpora project in 14 scheduled languages. Today, there is only one post of professor of corpora linguistics in the Indian Statistical Institute. No university in the country has a department. I blame the linguists for the declining fate of linguistics in India. Ever since independence, since our adoption of Macaulay's monomodal education system, in the name of specialization, we went on splitting subjects. Not only anthropology, sociology, and psychology were separated, anthropology was subdivided into physical and cultural, and sociology was subdivided into urban and rural. Social work and political science were separate subjects. geolinguistics, that is linguistic geography, linguistic paleontology, diachronic linguistics, sociolinguistics, psycholinguistics, anthropological linguistics, computational linguistics are subjects which are the interdisciplinary study. Neither the language departments nor the linguistics departments reflect any such concern. Few of the computer departments have NLP as a subject of research or application. It is not only in social science, in physical science also the same story is repeated. Recently, I heard an American Nobel laureate speaking about science education in one of the Indian universities. He said, the minimum unit of physics is atom. Through chemical processes, the atoms are combined to form the world. Through biological processes, animal kind and plant varieties are created. Where is science education if all three are not studied together? In different platforms, I have said that language, conversation, and is coterminous with the creation of humankind. Language is the medium of establishing human and environmental relationship. Language is a subject and medium of all subjects. There is no subject without a medium and no medium without the subject. Language is the medium of acquisition and transmission of knowledge. Language is the medium of sharing thoughts, feelings, and imaginations among humankind. Without language, social institutions like family, community, society, state, country would not have been possible. I have not seen any Indian scientist or social scientist talking about comprehensive integration. There is no wonder that new education policy talks about interdisciplinarity, intersubjectivity, and interculturality. Knowing the fact that none of the previous reports are fully implemented, and there is a huge gap between pronouncement and implementation, there is reason to be skeptical about the present announcement. Problems facing the world today is the growing number of persons who are excluded from meaningful participation in the economic, social, political, and cultural life of their community. Such a society is neither efficient nor safe. This is UNESCO in 2003. Ensuring social cohesion, meaning reduction of inequality and social exclusion in a multilingual country, particularly for the political and professional stakeholders, a biased view towards diversity and national languages is a major challenge. Language which plays a major role in social cohesion is considered as a divider and a barrier to development. Social scientists face a major challenge in sharing experiences and expectations and promote ethnic harmony and social inclusion. There is a lack of understanding that defense of diversity is the defense of sustainable development of an equalitarian global society. Language is the mirror of diversity. Languages have been undermined, particularly since independence of India. Even in the Constituent Assembly, which was preparing the Constitution, the ignorance about the role of language is evident. Ramakant Agnihotri, in his monograph on Indian Languages and the Constitution, justly captures the scenario when he writes, I quote, "It is true that no specific impact of the research on the nature, structure, acquisition, and diversity of language that was taking place throughout the world at that time is found in the debates of the constituent assembly output. The same is more or less true of the debates in the parliament. The linguists are trained, the linguistic curriculum are constricted. Intersubjectivity and interdisciplinarity are vanishing. We are still debating majority, minority, high, low, local, global. We are discussing paperless administration, teacherless education, and language-less artificial intelligence. For my generation, this is a devastating experience. Considering my age, this is probably the last ECOSOL I attend. I wish and pray that the present and future generation of linguists will be proficient in their subject and work together with other scientists to ensure social cohesion. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. It will be a great pleasure to listen to you again in future event. We wish you a sound health and years of active service ahead. Moving ahead, I would like to invite Professor Uma Rani Pappuswamy for the editorial remark on the launch of Indian Linguistic Volume 82, Issue 1 and 2. Let me introduce her. Professor Uma Rani Pappuswamy is presently the Professor cum Deputy Director at CIIL, and she has served as a Director in charge of the Institute in the year 2019. She has been the head of many prominent centers like Regional Language Center, Center of Language Documentation, Center of Northeast Language Development, Press and Publication Unit CIIL in the year 2017. And the head of Department of Linguistics, Northeastern University, Shillong, from the year 2011 to 2014, and has been a principal investigator in several projects in Nehu, Shillong, and CIIL Mysore. Over to you, ma'am, the session is yours.
Good evening, everybody. I request Professor Devi Prasanna Patnaik to formally launch Indian Linguistics, Volume 82-1-2, by touching the screen.
Button, huh?
Dr. Patna?
I now launch the Indian Linguistics.
Yes.
Thank you,
sir.
Thank you very much, sir. We are indeed very honored and privileged to have you launch Volume 82-1-2. It's really a memorable moment for all of us in the Linguistic Society of India to have you with us today. We are now very happy that even despite the pandemic, we got an opportunity to bring out two numbers of the Volume 82. Of course, as most of you know, I have been elected as the editor for the second time. I take this opportunity to thank each and every one of you present here and who are also not with us, but who are life members of the Linguistic Society of India for giving me a second term to serve you in the capacity of the editor. Of course, I started with a great deal of enthusiasm this year to bring many changes in the manuscript submission system and other related journal management issues. But unfortunately, as the world is still perturbed with the pandemic, bolted themselves again behind doors, and with the second lockdown in many parts of India, including Karnataka, where I currently live, most of the plans could not take off planned by us. Even so, the vision and the direction of the journal are neither blurred nor overshadowed by any of it. We strive hard to keep the journal going, and as always, I am, on the behalf of the Committee on Publications and myself, and on behalf of the President and Secretary LSI India and all other members of the prestigious society, place Indian Linguistics 82, 1 and 2, just launched by none other than our own beloved founder, director, Dr. D.P. Patnaik. This volume, of course, is here because of the continued efforts of many people. As you can see the names on the Committee on Publications, we have with us another professor, beloved Patnaik sir, with us, B.N. Patnaik, gracious Mary Thompson, and Dr. Rita Mathur. I believe they are also here with us. We have these three people on the committee.
Yeah.
The new committee. And this is the content page. This is the second page. Of course, this is as it appears in the press ready copy. This is the back cover of the journal. In this issue, we keep the editorial policies almost the same, except that my keen desire was to follow APA 7th edition guidelines to a larger extent, especially with regard to references, as some of you might notice when the journal is in your hands. Like you will see that in the 7th edition, the place of publication is no longer necessary with regard to references. And we are also trying to bring in other small changes. I first thought, why not we use unified style of linguistics as followed by language launched by Linguistic Society of America, but then it was very difficult to do the transition immediately. And I thought like, okay, let us go with this year with the same, but at least we will stick as close as possible to the 7th edition. So that is why we are using this. And we do have plans to make other changes with the committee. And also we are setting up an editorial board as well, which you will see in the next volume perhaps. Turning to this issue, you can see we have a diverse selection of interesting articles from scholars like Shobhna Chellia, Mary Book, and Marty Heaton. The first article is on using interlinear gloss text to improve language description. We have another article on lexicography, especially expressives, by Nathan, Osa, Madhu, and Onishi. We also were very happy to include Yogendra Yadava's article on Nepal's contemporary linguistic landscape, its implications for language endangerment. And also, in the same way, we were happy to introduce student articles also. We have Akansha, we have, I think, maybe Reena. We have two student articles also, and other people also, all our members. Indra Kumar Singh's work on Manipuri word formation, and Vasanta's work on Telugu idiophones. Oh. And publication committee member Rita Mathur's article on social linguistics, bilingual first language acquisition. And also at this moment, we also wanted to remember Dr. Hemanga Datta, who passed away this year during the pandemic. So this volume also was getting ready at the same time. And that is why we thought like we should include his work. In fact, he has also submitted his paper. I think I would request someone who knows optimality theory on phonology to look into the reviewer's comments and help me bring out his paper. I think that's another honor we want to do. So we do have, and besides this, we are getting submissions worldwide, and I hope in the next volumes you will see so many other items. And one more thing, as an editor, I would like to say, I request the President LSI to submit the presidential address of this year's talk, at least for the next next 2 years. I would like to include your article. That should be the beginning of the next volume. The first article should be the President's address, as it used to be in earlier days. So I am looking forward for your article. I thank the LSI for giving us an opportunity to release this journal formally and placing it in your hands. Thank you, everyone. I also thank my colleagues, the organizing committee of this particular conference, they called C43, for making this happen. And thanks to CIL director for hosting and patronizing this conference. Thank you, everyone.
That's good. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for the speech. The next renowned to honor us with his presence is the coordinator of ICALC 43, Sri Sujoy Sarkar, with the conference report. Let me introduce him. Sri Sujoy Sarkar is the lecturer cum junior research officer at CIIL, and he is the officer in charge for a scheme for protection and preservation of endangered language project, and he is the coordinator of ICALC 43. Over to you, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Nisha. Good afternoon. Namaskar, all of you present here, all the respected teachers, other scholars from different universities and institute. So let me brief you about the conference ICALC or ICALC 43. This year we had one keynote address by Professor Martin Espelmeth, Radhabhai Khatre Memorial Lecture by Professor K.B. Subbarao, plenary lecture one by Professor Masato Kobayashi, plenary lecture two by Professor Deepti Mishra, plenary lecture three by Professor Madhav Deshpande. This year we received 230 abstract in different areas of linguistics, literature, and interdisciplinary areas. Among 230 abstract, we have selected 175 abstract for presentation during these 3 days in four parallel session. 11 presenters were not able to present their paper because of different reason. 6 of them could not join because of the poor connection. So you can note down this data for the future that 6 presenters could not join for poor connectivity. Before the conference, we try to make it as smooth as possible. Because of that, we send all the presenter test links so they can test their connectivity and PPT. So we can save our time, also can check the connectivity that can be the presenter can make possible or not. So this was the gist of the academic activities of this ICALC 31. I think that's it. Thank you. Nisha, please, you can take over and invite the next one.
Sir, we are charmed by your enthusiasm. Next, I would like to invite Professor G. Uma Maheshwara Rao, the president of LSI, for the president's remark. So let me introduce him. Dr. Rao has worked as a director of the Center for Applied Linguistics and Translation Studies at the University of Hyderabad. He has also served as a former president at Dravidian Linguistics Association and as a member of General Council Kendriya Sahitya Academy. Professor Rao has actively contributed to the field of computational linguistics, and he is among the very few linguists trained in historical linguistics. His idea in the field of morphology has influenced many linguists. He has been an inspiration for several generations of linguistics in the country. The session is yours, sir.
Thank you. Yeah, I take this as a great honor to address you now. Dear Professor Devi Prasanna Patnaik ji, yes, sir. He is the founder, director of CIL, Mysore, and many senior colleagues, friends, and students who have assembled here. It is time to express our gratitude to the organizers of this ICALC 43, a great success we got for this year. I should convey a special thanks to Professor Martin Hespelmath, who has readily agreed when we approached him, who has delivered also the keynote address on language description and language universals in the inaugural session of the conference. I also thank Sri Radhakrishnan Chair Professor K.V. Subbarao Garu for delivering Srimati Radhabai Khatre Memorial Lecture on Lexical Anaphors in South Asian Languages and some salient features, and Professor Masato Kobayashi for delivering the plenary lecture on Dravidian and Kuruk Malto K past on what outlier languages tell us about reconstruction. And Professor Madhav Deshpande, University of Michigan, has delivered the third plenary on the Vedic tradition and the origins of grammatical thought in ancient India. And Professor Deepthi Mishra Sharma from IIT Hyderabad has delivered the second plenary on Can Machine Translation Help in Translation? And finally, I thank Padma Shri Professor Devi Prasanna Patanayak Ji for his valedictory address in the concluding session of the conference. Just now we have heard that one. I thank the director of CIL and the secretary of LSA in conducting this conference with his fellow researcher team in a smoother way. I thank Professor Umar Rani Papusamy for bringing the Indian Linguistics volume readily here. That is 82 volume, and issues 1 and 2 are by our beloved Professor Patnaik Ji. I also thank the Vice President and other office bearers and the members of EC of LSA for their cooperation in conducting this conference a great success. I also thank all the delegates who have participated in the conference for the last 3 days and online, and also some of those organizers sitting at Mysore in the CIL and conducting it to a great success. I thank the former presidents of the society who have enriched it by their relentless deeds in achieving the goals. And thank you very much for this kind of opportunity you gave me. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Rao, for your remark and your graceful presence. Next, may I request Professor Sailendra Mohan, Director of CIIL, to join us for the chairperson's remark. Let me introduce him. Professor Sailendra Mohan is a linguist and an academician with more than 19 years of teaching experience at Deccan College Postgraduate and Research Institute, Pune. He has done an extensive fieldwork working on scores of major and minor languages of India. His wide study includes extensive research on an endangered language and a language isolate called Nihali, spoken in central India. He also specializes in linguistic studies on Munda language, a language family spread across India that includes languages like Santhali, Kuruk, Kharia, Khasi, and so on. Professor Sailendra Mohan has contributed a lot to language studies in India through his teaching and scores of research paper and books prior to joining CIIL. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Namaskara. Yellaragu Namaskara. Padma Shri Professor D.P. Patnaik, guest of honor to this valedictory session function. President LSI, Professor Uma Maheshwar Rao Garu, coordinators of ECO LSI 43, Dr. Tari, Sri Sujoy, Sri Alindra, Dr. L.R. Prem Kumar, Dr. Pankaj Dwivedi, all the paper presenters and participants to this ECO LSI 43, my colleagues from CIL Mysore, friends from the media and friends, it is my pleasure to begin by greeting you all. I thank Professor D.P. Patnaik for providing insights for all of us in his valedictory address. Sir, we'll try to improve the status of linguistics as a subject in near future, and also we'll try to promote interdisciplinary research in future as well. though some of the university have started that, but it is a time to start rethinking on it. And I also believe that CIL will take new initiatives, new ventures into new areas of research and development of Indian languages in future, particularly in Northeast region of India. Also the tribal and minor languages spoken in India. We need to document and disseminate to our stakeholders. We also need to develop good amount of digital corpus in all schedule, 22 schedule languages to cope with this digital world. I would like to add that CIL has signed MOUs with the social media giant Koo, and we are also in discussions with many more organizations, academic institutions, both public and private, and multinational companies for a long-term academic and research collaboration. So in the last 3 days, we have learned a lot from our young scholars and senior scholars in the field of linguistics. I wish to express my deep sense of happiness and satisfaction that we have been able to organize this conference successfully. Once again, I extend my warm wishes to all delegates, President of LSI and Professor D.P. Patnaik and other respected members of Linguistic Society of India, coordinators of the event, academicians and scholars, my colleagues from CIL, session chairs and presenters, volunteers, and one and all for their kind patronage and contribution for the successful organization of this conference. I would like to end with a quote from Paninian Siksha, which states that iti varnavida parhul punyam tang nibodhata. That the meaning is, thus the linguists have spoken, understand this wisely. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much, Professor Sailendra Mohan, for gracing us with your special presence. Almost heading towards the end of the valedictory session, I would like to request Dr. Pankaj Dwivedi to deliver the vote of thanks. Let me introduce him. Dr. Pankaj Dwivedi is an officer in charge at National Testing Service India, MHRD, Government of India, overall in charge Hindi teaching scheme, CIIL Mysuru, Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India, Officer in Charge Educational Technology Unit CIIL Mysuru. He is a lecturer cum junior research professor in CIIL from February 2016 onwards, worked as an assistant professor at Department of Computational Linguistics in Mahatma Gandhi International Hindi University, Wardha, Maharashtra, India from August 2014 onwards to April 2015. Has worked as a teaching assistant at IIT Roper, Punjab from August 2011 till February 2016 and has worked as an assistant professor at Department of Applied Linguistics and Humanities in GLA University, Mathura, UP from September 2009 to June 2011. Over to you, sir.
Am I audible to everybody? Can somebody confirm, am I audible?
Yes,
sir. Yes.
ಎಲ್ಲಾರ್ಗು ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ, ನಮಸ್ಕಾರಂ, ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ, ಆದಾಬ್, ವಡಕ್ಕಂ, ಸಸ್ರಿಯ ಕಾಲ್, ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ. ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಲೆಜೆಂಡ್ ಪದ್ಮಶ್ರೀ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೌಂಡರ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಐಎ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಡಿ ಪಿ ಪಟ್ನಾಯಕ್ ಸಾಹಬ್, ಆನರೇಬಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಲಿಂಗ್ವಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಜಿ ಉಮಾ ಮಹೇಶ್ವರ ರಾವ್ ಗಾರು, ಆನರೇಬಲ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಮೈಸೂರು ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಶೈಲೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋಹನ್ ಸಾಹಬ್, respected academicians and scholars from India and other parts of the world. My senior professors, Professor Dr. Uma Pappurani Madam, Professor Dr. P.R. Dharmesh Fernandez Sahab, Professor Dr. Shiv Ramakrishna Sahab, and other colleagues from CIL, friends, ladies, and gentlemen. I also extend a very warm welcome to all of you in the valedictory session of 43rd International Conference of Linguistic Society of India in collaboration with Central Institute of Indian Language, Mysuru. I2LSI started in 1970 under the name of All India Conference of Linguists, AICL, And definitely we have come a very long way, 50 long years. And this has become possible only with the patronage, with the guidance and support from all of you. Friends, somebody has said it, if you are feeling thankful, you know, and grateful, and you are not expressing it, so it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. So I should not commit this mistake. And I will also quote one very important, you know, line by the Prophet Muhammad. He says in the Al-Bukhari, Manalam yas kurinasa lamayas kurilaha. The Prophet says, whoever did not thank the people, did not thank the God. So I should not commit that mistake. I should definitely thank each and everybody, whosoever has been providing his kind patronage, support and guidance in the organization of the program. And therefore, this is the time and we must acknowledge those people. All right. And so first and foremost, I would like to convey my thanks to Honorable President, Linguistic Society of India, Professor Dr. G. Uma Maheswar Rao Garu, for his exceptional leadership of the LSI and kind patronage to the program. Thank you so very much, sir. We are very, very grateful to you. And I also take opportunity to thank Madam Vice President, Professor Dr. Shobha Satyanath, and other office bearers of LSI for their guidance and support in the successful organization of the event. Thereafter, my sincere and respectful thanks are due to Professor Dr. Shailendra Mohan Sahab, Director CIL Mysuru, for his constant guidance and support to the event. CIL has been an integral partner of the LSI in its academic and research ventures, and I wish may our association keep going forward always. Now, friends, it is time to thank the keynote speakers as well as the plenary speakers. So my first thanks goes to Professor Martin Abselmath from Max Planck Institute for Science of Human History, who delivered a thought-provoking keynote on language description and language universal, despite, you know, our timings at his end and other technical constraints. Thank you so very much, sir. I'm sure that someone from the organizing committee will also thank you over the email as well as over the phone. My humble thanks are also due to, you know, our very beloved and very respected Professor K.V. Subba Rao, sir, for delivering Radhabai Katre Memorial Lecture on the lexical anaphores in the South Asian languages. Sir, as usual, it's always both pleasure and privilege to listen to you. And I, you know, aspire to become a classroom teacher like you. So please bless me. And I'm sure that somebody will, you know, like if you are here, then you must be blessing me as well. Thank you so much, sir. I would also like to convey my sincere thanks to Professor Masato Kobayashi from University of Tokyo, Japan, for his wonderful and deeply insightful plenary lecture on the Dravidian and the Kuruk Malto, K-Past, what outlier language tells about the reconstruction. And I remember that even, you know, after your lecture, we were discussing that how wonderful, you know, it was, and we kept admiring it for a very long time. Thank you so much, sir. And my special thanks are also due to Professor Dr. Deepthi Mishra, Madam, from IIIT Hyderabad, for a very relevant and very important lecture, you know, titled Can Machine Translation Help in Translation? Thank you so much, ma'am. Ma'am, you know, in India, any budding linguist, any young linguist or a young scholar, when they want to venture into the area of computational linguistics or the machine translation or natural language processing, so you are one among those person like to whom we all look up to. And I'm sure there are many, many young scholars for whom you are a role model. And of course, the young, small, you know, women linguists, young students, they feel empowered just by your presence. Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving your, you know, wonderful time. And friends, I would also like to convey my heartfelt thanks to Professor Madhav Deshpande from University of Michigan for his plenary talk on the Vedic tradition and the origins of grammatical thoughts in ancient India. You see, I have been recently reading a book by Professor Peggy Mohan, and I hope that everybody's aware with the title, The Vandras, Kings and the Merchants, the Story of India Through Its Languages. And in that book, Professor Peggy Mohan has several times mentioned the name of Professor Madhav Deshpande and his thought-provoking interaction with Professor Peggy Mohan. And so when I saw and heard him for the first time, it was a sheer pleasure for me. Thank you so very much, sir. And I hope in the future as well, we'll keep receiving your patronage and guidance to our programs. And friends, now is the time. I would like to try to convey my thanks, you know, to a person before whom I feel confident and nervous at the same time, stronger and weaker at the same time. And before him, I also feel proud and fearful at the same time. And, you know, he is none other than our very beloved Padma Professor D.P. Patnaik Sahab. And I thank him, I congratulate him for his wonderful valedictory lecture. But, you know, I think I will need few more PhDs and perhaps few more decades of experience to be to become the worthy to say anything in his praise. So, sir, please accept my humble pranam from Mysuru, and with Sanskrit, with one Sanskrit phrase, I would like to say, Kritagyo Asmi. Thank you so very much, sir, and, you know, for taking out time from the busy schedule, and we are, you know, sheer gratitude. Thank you so much, sir. And friends, I would also like to convey my thanks to all the chairs of the keynote session, plenary session, you know, and other technical session for their guidance and support during the paper presentation and other technical session. And it's not possible for me to take all the names, but however, it's important to make, you know, mention of the few. So I'll just take the name one by one. And if I miss anybody's name, please forgive me. And I have also not put the names of my friends, Miss, who are my colleague at CIL, because I would wish to thank them over a cup of coffee after all, you know, this virtual meeting is over. So I'll take the name. First name is Professor Dr. G. Uma Maheshwar Rao Garu, then Professor Dr. Krishna Bhattacharya Madam from University of Calcutta, Professor Dr. Panchanand Mohanty, former Professor CALS, University of Hyderabad, presently he is in JLA University, Mathura. Professor Audesh Kumar Mishra from English and Foreign Language University, Shillong Campus. He's also former director of CIL Mysuru. Professor Shailendra Mohan Saab, director CIL Mysuru. Professor Dr. Tanmay Bhattacharya from Department of Linguistics, University of Delhi. And, you know, I was chairing the session and Professor Bhattacharya just joined. And he was just guiding the student. And I was so happy. I was so relieved. Then at that time, I remembered a quote. The quote says, the value of college education is not the learning of many facts, but the training of mind to think. The way Professor Bhattacharya was guiding, you know, so I aspire to, you know, become like him one day. I mean, the way he chaired the session, the way he provides input to the student. And I also remember there was, you know, one very young student. I don't remember her name, and because of some technical glitches, network glitches, she was unable to join in. But with the support, with the motivation of Professor Bhattacharya, she made it through, and it was wonderful to listen to her. She was very confident. So thank you so much, sir. And I would also like to express my thanks to Professor Rajesh Sasdeva, former director CIL Mysuru, then Professor Dr. Uma Rani, Pappu Swami Madam, deputy director CIL Mysuru, from whom I constantly seek guidance and other support, and she has never ever said no to me or, you know, later on, these kind of words. She's always ready to help me and everybody else. I also would like to thank Professor P.R. Dharmesh Fernandes, Deputy Director CIL Mysuru, and who has also been integral part of this program, and we have been receiving his constant support and guidance in the organization of the program. I would also like to express my thanks to Professor Rajesh Kumar from IIT Madras, Professor Rajendra Ness from Amrita Vishwa Vidyapeetham, Dr. Hari Madhav Rai from JNU New Delhi, Dr. Dripta Piplai, IIT Kharagpur, Dr. Ravindranath, University of Mysuru, Dr. Paroma Sanyal, IIT Delhi, Professor Niladri Shekhar Das Sir from ISI Kolkata, Professor Lakshmi Haribandi, Madam, English and Foreign Language University, Hyderabad, Dr. L. Ramamurthy, my senior professor from CIL Mysuru. Thank you so very much, sir. Professor Dr. Shivram Krishna Saab from CIL Mysuru, Dr. V. Karta from National Institute of Technology, Trichy. Also, Dr. Parman Singh, H.S. Agra, who is currently at Mysuru Center of, you know, Kendri Hindi Sasthan Agra. Dr. Niranjan Upur from Tripura University, Dr. Amlesh Go from Tejpur University, Dr. Udayan Banerjee, Department of Linguistics, Banaras Hindu University, Dr. Samir Karmakar from Jadavpur University, Dr. Umesh Kumar, Department of English, Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi, Dr. Ritesh Kumar from Dr. B.R. Ambedkar University, Agra. And my apologies if I have missed any name. I have tried my best, and hopefully I have taken everybody's name, all the chairs. I would also like to thank, friends, the presenter for their wonderful papers, for, you know, wonderful talks. After all, any conference, you know, becomes a good conference by the
the kind of paper, you know, the kind of research it has. So I think this conference has been very, very, very fruitful, like everybody said. And finally, friends, I'd like to thank the most important part of any academic event or any other event. These are the volunteers. You know, there are various volunteers. They don't have the first place in the title page or in the conference, but these are the most important people. And there's a complete team. And I hope I will take everybody's name. So there are several teams. I'll just take the name of the team and the name of the people then. So from technical team, I would like to convey my thanks to Mr. Praveen Raj and Mr. Tejas, Mr. Harish from MTM, and Ms. Manjula from NTM. And from the publication team, I would like to convey my thanks to Dr. Murli Mohan from National Testing Service India. And like you have seen the book of abstract, so this has been the work of three persons: Dr. Dinkar Prasad from NTM, Ms. Sri Lakshmi from NTM, Ms. Ashwini from NTM, and there are session managers. These are those people who have been contacting the presenters and the chairs. You know, these people have acted at a very important place. So Dr. Biresh Kumar from NTS, Dr. R. Shakuntla from NTS, Dr. Amit Kumar Jha, Dr. Dinkar Prasad, Ms. Juni Malik from NTM, Dr. Mehdibo Dafro from NTM, Ms. Sumangala Devi P from NTM, Mr. Shubhanan Mondal, and Ms. Nisha Upadhyay. And these are those people who have been comparing all along. They have given, you know, all of their time to this conference. Thank you so very much to both of you. And then Mr. Nirav Mathur from SPIL, Mr. Arya Navya from SPIL, and Mr. Anustu Bhattacharya, and the sitar, the music which you heard during the inauguration ceremony, I think that was played by Mr. Anustu Bhattacharya. So thank you so much, Dev. All of them have so tirelessly worked for many days for the successful organization of the event. So thank you all of you. And friends, you know, now earlier, like people mentioned, the COVID, etc. And of course, still all of the world is suffering, including India. I would like to end this with the one Sanskrit shloka: Sarve bhavantu sukhina, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhadrani pasyantu, ma kashchi durbhag bhavet. Sab sukhi hove, sab roop nirog mukt hove, sab mangalmay ke sakshi bane, aur kisi ko bhi dukh ka bhagi na banna pade. Inhi mangal kamnaon ke sath, aap sabhi ka dil mangalmay ho. Over to the, thank you so very much, sir. Thank you so much, everybody.
Thank you, Dr. Pankaj Dwivedi, for the vote of thanks and the acknowledgement. With your permission, we are now closing the valedictory session with the national anthem. Please keep your audios and videos off, and you may also stand in reverence to the national anthem as the tune plays in the background.
Okay.